Hi, my name is Brecht Castel. I'm a Belgian journalist and I love online investigations. In this episode, we start from a picture on Facebook, which was seen over a million times. The person who put it online says this is a tree in Senegal and the tree is 6,000 years old. Let's find out. First, I downloaded this picture and then I could do a reverse image search with a site called StinEye. This is a very good site for reverse image search, certainly if the picture is shared widely on the web, because we can sort them by date. Nowadays, I sort them by oldest first, and we have a version from 2012 and one from 2010. Let's open these websites and see if we find the same picture. On this page, it doesn't seem to be the case, but here we have some luck, because this is a photography website from a photographer called Michael Fairchild, and here we find the same picture. But the caption doesn't have much details. It just says it's a baobab tree with some children somewhere in Africa. I opened Google Earth Pro. This is a great tool for geolocation. So, okay, the tree is somewhere in Africa. That's not enough information. So I went to Flickr and I found the profile of this photographer, Michael Fairchild. In the album Children of the World, I found the same picture, which we can see here. And luckily, here in the caption, we have some more details. We see the photographer wrote the picture was taken in a little Namibian village. So we can narrow it down a bit. The tree should be somewhere here in Namibia, not in Senegal. But of course, it's impossible to find with only this information. So I looked a bit further. I found this album with some other pictures of trees and they look like the same tree. Of course, we have to be sure, but when I clicked on this picture, I saw that it stated that this is in a village on Impalila Island. I compared two pictures and it seems to be the same tree. So we are looking for a tree somewhere on Impalila Island, a small piece of Namibia. Well, small, it's not that small, actually. If we look a bit further, we see it's still a vast amount of surface to look for. We see a lot of trees, we see villages, but we definitely see too much trees, you know, so it's hard to find. I went to YouTube and I typed in Impalila to find some videos of this region, and I noticed an interesting video which I'll show you in a bit. I'll put out the most interesting parts from this village tour on Impalila Island.
This is the Namibian border on the Impalila Island. This is the Namibian immigration office at Impalila Island, and I'm just going to stamp my passport and then we're off on our village tour. So we are starting on our village walk, and the village we are going to visit is the Gafobo village. So we are entering into the Gafobo village, and I can see from here that is the one big baobab tree in the middle of the village.
Now I want to reconstruct this walk from this vlogger. So I went to Google Maps to reconstruct it from the migration office to this village Gafobo, but unfortunately Google Maps doesn't have a lot of detail for this region. Actually, we don't see anything. We don't see the village. We don't see the migration of it. So I had to work around this. I went to Google and I searched for sites from Namibia. I do this by a trick, site colon NA for Namibia and then Impalila. By this way, I came to a website from the Impalila Conservancy. And luckily here we find a map with some more detail. I'll show you now. This is the Impalila Island immigration control between Namibia and Botswana. And here we found this village Gafobo. So if we compare this with Google Earth, we can retrace the track from this vlogger on YouTube and we can find the tree we are looking for. So let's compare this satellite imagery with this map. I think the control office should be somewhere here. Let's zoom in a bit. Yeah, I think it should be here. So I think one of these buildings is the migration office. From the video, I know in which direction this guy was walking. So I go in the same direction to find the village. And I think this might be it. So let's turn around. Let's get in the same angle as the vlogger on YouTube to compare the satellite imagery with the pictures from YouTube. So if I compare the two, we see we have a match. We see the same trees on the same positions. We see the same path, and we see the Baobab tree in the center of the village. Small recap, we did a reverse image search to find the photographer. We found some information on Flickr. We found some information on YouTube, and we could retrace the track from this vlogger to find the exact location of the Baobab tree, which is exactly here. Only one question remains: how old is this tree? Well, I found guesses from 100 years old to 6,000 years old, but that's definitely an exaggeration because the oldest tree found so far in Africa is only 2,450 years old. So 6,000 years old is definitely not true. I hope you liked it. Share this video and subscribe for more.